If there is one company that signifies the word luxury as well as technology more than any other, it has got to be Mercedes-Benz. And after having been in the business of making cars for nearly a century and still being one of the foremost car makers in the world, you can bet that these people know how to survive. So it's no surprise that with the global drive towards electrification in cars, Mercedes has also been eager to make its statement in this newly emerging industry. And well, with the release of the latest EQS, I don't think there's anything left to say except the fact that Mercedes has made the single most luxurious electric car in existence. So if you're interested in that and want to find out more, watch till the end because we'll tell you all there is to know about this paragon of luxury. What is the EQS? To understand the answer to that question, let's take a look at some context. Although for most people out there, Tesla is basically synonymous with the first electric car, no one seems to be aware of the fact that Mercedes actually filed a patent for an electric car all the way back in 1906. Now, that obviously didn't work out since the company is not only used to making gas engines, but is one of the absolute best ones out there. However, part of that spirit seems to have found its way back into the modern day, because they've not only been one of the first major companies to adopt the electric powertrain, but are really going ham on it. And then there's the company's brand image. Let's face it, when you think of Mercedes, you think of luxury cars. And when you think of luxury cars, you think of Mercedes. And not just any Mercedes, mind you, no. We're talking about the cream of the crop, the greatest Mercedes that the company makes, the S-Class. Known for its immaculate build, care in each and every detail, and comfort that rivals heaven, the S-Class is, and has been, the company's proud child for a while now. And that's where the EQS comes in, because you guessed it, the S at the end stands for the S-Class status, meaning that this car is basically the final word in Mercedes' statement on how they're going to do electric cars. So it's no wonder that there is a lot riding on it. Now that we know what it is, let's take a look at some of the most important bits, starting with the powertrain. Besides being the makers of the most comfortable interiors on Earth, another thing Mercedes is known for is some of the most impressive engines, particularly their Mercedes-AMG subsidiary, which provides engines to even the biggest of brands like Pagani. And as a result, it's no shock that they provided the car that will literally define their future with the most well-made electric powertrain they could think of. Now, as it turns out, in the case of the EQS, that is not one motor setup, but two separate ones, the one for the standard EQS and one for its more expensive version, the EQS 4MATIC, with the former having a single motor setup and rear-wheel drive, and the latter having two motors that give it four-wheel drive, resulting in the 4MATIC name. And as expected, they provide extremely competitive stats to boot, with the standard EQS, or EQS 450 Plus, giving us a high and mighty 329 horsepower and 406 foot-pounds of torque, and the bigger one giving a very respectable 516 horses and 611 foot-pounds of torque. With all that power, we're going to all four wheels for higher maneuverability and traction. Performance. Now, unfortunately, those numbers are still dwarfed by the best of the EQ competition, namely companies like Tesla, whose power easily goes beyond 1,000 horsepower. However, the fact that Mercedes is, well, Mercedes, means that they know what they're doing. And one of those things is the fact that raw power is useless without a suitable suspension, braking, tire, and other associated systems. And as countless reviewers have already mentioned, in general everyday tasks and on races that are not a straight line, the car excels more than you could ever expect. It's also not like the straight line performance is bad, since the EQS 450 can accelerate from 0 to 60 miles per hour in about 5.5 seconds and reach a top speed of 130 miles per hour, while the bigger and badder EQS 580 4MATIC can launch itself to 62 miles per hour in just 4.1 seconds, which again might not be Tesla ludicrous speeds, but mind you, that's also what a lot of Porsche 911 drivers get, and those guys don't seem to be missing out on anything. And then there's the other distinction, the design. Another thing besides the driving and technical experience a company like Mercedes gets just from having as much of an experience alone is a design sense that rivals actual design studios. And the same can be said for Mercedes. From the beautiful gullwing cars of the past to the sleek and gorgeous S and E classes of today, few companies can match the fine line of a Mercedes. And well, with the EQS hemming the arrival of a new era, it was expected that the design team would deliver here as well. And deliver they did. A sleek and elegant design that looks classy while also being futuristic, with an LED area where the grille should be, providing the standard Mercedes style, and the small LEDs adorning it, giving it that from a different timeline feel. Built to stand out, the EQS is more than just another electric vehicle. One look at the EQS and the resemblance to the Vision EQS Concept 2019 becomes pretty clear. While certainly not as futuristic as the concept car, the EQS does share quite a bit. From the curvilinear finish with sweeping lines to the wide front grille, the EQS stands in a league of its own. And that's not even considering the fact that it's an electric vehicle, which, let's be honest, until recently has been seriously lacking in the design department. I don't think anyone can say that this car looks anything but stunning, and that's without even mentioning the inside. Interior luxury. Sure, the outside of the car is fancy, but it's the inside where the prowess of the Mercedes design department really shines. The front seats give a distinct impression that you're flying a spaceship, and to complement just that, the dashboard has an MBUX Hyperscreen infotainment system offering more than 377 square inches of visual space. The MBUX Hyperscreen is by far the most visually appealing dashboard you'll ever come across, and the fact that it has integrated OLED screens is an added bonus. The dashboard is divided into three screens, one for the driver, one for the passengers in the back, and the last one for the front passenger. The 12.3-inch driver's display will act as a digital gauge cluster from which you can monitor the car and the progress of the journey. The 17-inch infotainment and 12.3-inch passenger displays are for the passengers to select entertainment options, check out their route, and adjust the climate control settings. The screens have been built to be as seamless as possible and have integrated AC grills to make the experience even better. The seats of the car aren't any less exciting than the screen. And apart from being covered with quilted leather, also offer massages. Yes, you heard that right. Massage chairs have also been installed in the car. There are a bunch of other features too, including ambient lighting, a HEPA filtration system, and in-cabin soundscapes meant to calm and soothe. Battery and charging. Mercedes set some really high expectations after it reported that the EQS lineup will feature a range of more than 400 miles. Unfortunately, Mercedes failed to deliver on that promise, and the range of the EQS 450 Plus ended up being just 350 miles, and as for the all-wheel drive EQS 584-matic, it's even lower at just 340 miles. Now, these numbers aren't low by any means, and the chances of you going below 50% on your daily commute is slim to none. However, that does not mean the news isn't disappointing. Anyway, the battery is a lithium-ion pack with 107.8 kilowatt-hours of usable storage and charges from 10 to 80 in just 35 minutes. Take away the fast charger, however, and a regular Level 2 charger is going to need more than 11 hours to fully charge this bad boy. In terms of real-life usage, this is still pretty good, and you can just plug in the car at night with no worries if it's going to need more juice in the morning. Pricing. Moving on to arguably the most important part of the video, we've got the pricing. Mercedes has a habit of blowing its competitors out of the water, and that is exactly what it is doing here. Most companies introduce a significant jump in price when shifting from gas-powered vehicles to electric ones. Mercedes, however, has done the exact opposite, and the EQS is actually cheaper than the S-Class. The starting price for the EV is $7,490 less than the S-Class. Pricing for the entry-level premium trim package starts at $102,310 for the EQS 450 Plus, going up to $119,110 for the EQS 584-matic. As for the exclusive package, that starts at $105,710 for the 450 Plus and $122,510 for the EQS 584-matic. Finally, the epitome of finesse, the pinnacle trim, will start at $108,510 for the 450 Plus and $125,310 for the EQS 584-matic. And well, on that note, we must end today's video. I hope you enjoyed watching it, and if you did, be sure to leave a like and subscribe for more. With that, take care, and I'll see you guys next time.